The next topic is causes of deterioration. The following are the causes of failure of the structure. So number one, occurrences incidental to construction stage, that is at the time of construction. This could be number one, local settlement of subgrade. So subgrade means at the base, okay, and that base may leads to settlement, so that the mislead of or misplacing of the structures and footings, etc., it may happen. Number two, movement of formwork. Movement of formwork is due to loading, unloading, so that the formwork get disturbed, so that the alignment in the structure may get vary. Vibrations. So vibration means at the time of concreting, we may use some vibrators. So that vibrator should not touch the outer surface that is covered with scaffoldings. That should not be get disturbed. So that may lead to deterioration. Internal settlement of concrete suspension. So more due to overweight of the concrete again and again overlaying, setting stinkage, so the cracks may develop, the stinkage crack may develop due to change in the temperatures. Premature removal of forms. So the formwork may be in some cases premature, the concrete is not even settled. We may remove that formwork by estimating that 10 days is enough or 14 days is enough, but due to temperature changes, due to continuous change, the concrete may not settle. Or due to some other material reason, slow settling cement may be there. So premature of removal of forms will cause some deterioration. And B, second type is drying stinkage. So there is again a stinkage cracks which will develop in the structure that we already studied in the concrete technology. And temperature stresses, as we already discussed in about Chennai airport. So this may be due to differences in temperature between inside of the building with its environment. So inside of the building, room temperature will be less, and outside the structure, the temperature will be more. So this may lead to develop some cracks. Variation in internal temperature of the building or structure. So internal temperature also sometimes it may get varied due to in summer season, it may, we may keep, for example, if it is air conditioned structure like airports, hospitals, etc. So the airports normally they depends on the crowd, they will increase the temperature. And immediately the crowd gets decreased, if the temperature remains same, so that may also lead to some development of stresses in the structure. And D is absorption of moisture by the concrete. So all we know that the concrete will absorb some moisture content after immediately after the curing. So that may due to more absorption of moisture will also lead to deterioration. Corrosion of reinforcement. This may be caused by two reasons. Number one, entry of moisture through cracks or pores. Again, the moisture will get entry into the concrete structure by cracks or any pores in the concrete, and the electrolytic action. Next point is aggressive action of chemicals. So chemical means again that materials which are used in the concrete admixtures or any other structures which may fall over the concrete surface due to wind. So that are all chemical aggressive actions, weathering actions due to the temperature, action of shock waves, so any disturbed in structures, and it may due to erosion also. That means that is. And next is poor design details. So the poor design details means that re-entrant corners, changes in cross section, rigid joints in precast elements, and deflections. So poor details, it leads to changes in cross section means we are planned for 300 by 230 and later on it may be developed for 300 by 300, or align may get, we may kept in longitudinal direction due to request of the client, it may change to some other alignment. So that may be we are considering only at the design factors while we are doing in field without the knowledge of structural engineer or the engineer who has designed the building, that should be taken care. Otherwise it may also lead to deterioration. That's what the in poor design details it was mentioned. And rigid elements. Rigid means you know that fixed. So it may be due to more stresses. It may due to more stresses. It may shrink or expansion and contraction. Again, it will lead to deterioration. The deflection due to overloading or some failures, it may happen. So these above 4 points are lead to leakage through the joints. So in the corners, if you are not finishing or not joining properly, the leakage will appear. Inadequate drainage. Yes. So the drainage will get stuck, inefficient drainage slopes, unanticipated shear stress in piers, pier again columns, brick piers normally used to say that brick columns normally we used to say that pier columns and abutments. Incompatibility of materials of sections, neglect in the design. So the above reasons will lead to this. Next is errors in design. Yes, due to the errors, that means giving a improper section, improper material, using of improper materials, that may lead to deterioration. Errors in earlier repair. So we want to notify that, or we want to wait for that, whether the crack will develop for particular length or it may arrest within the short duration, without knowing that, by just we are assuming that by giving some more length or width of the crack to be patched and then taking care of the repair work, that is not advisable. So we want to wait for some particular time to repair the cracks. Overloading, again external influences such as earthquake, that is not in our hands, and wind, fire, cyclone, so we can't able to judge all those things. The earthquake may be depends on the Richter scale, and wind may be depends on the kilometer per hour or meter per second as per IS 875 part 3. Maximum is 55 meter per second only in India map, whereas we may felt sometimes 60 meter per second also. So that is not, we can't able to take into action. Fire accidents and cyclones. Design and construction flows. Design of the concrete structures governs the performance of concrete structures. Well designed and detailed concrete structures will show less deterioration. That's what each and every time we are mentioning, that if the structure is well designed and well detailed concrete, then there is no chance of getting failure in comparison with poor design and detailed concrete in this similar condition. So well designed and detailed concrete structure will always withstand for its life duration. The beam column joints are particularly prone to defective concrete if detailing and playing of reinforcement is not done properly. So in the field, many engineers are facing problems at the beam column junction only. So as per 3920 or some other codal condition, we are projecting the beam, bending the beam to column points and column to beam at the top floor. So at the joint, the settlement of concrete will facing some problems, so that we can't able to compact it properly. The concrete will not insert properly. So these problems may due to defective in concrete. If the reinforcement detailing work in the drawing should be given very carefully, so that only the work can be carried out in the perfect manner, as well as the work should be taken care by the bar bender also, very particular in the dimension as well as very particular in bending with the correct angle, so that only all the errors can be removed and the structure will be more good in concreting. Inadequate concrete cover may lead to carbonation. Yes, so our government is asking us to wear mask, and the mask should be cover both the nose as well as our mouth, whereas somebody is putting a mask for only for mouth and somebody is putting only for nose, that is not good. So like that, the concrete cover should be in the perfect manner by giving proper spacing, depends on the structural elements. For beam, it is some particular dimension cover should be given. For column, on a particular cover should be given. For footings, again everything is available in the code book. So that particular concrete, inadequate concrete cover means, then it may lead to carbonation depths reaching up to the reinforcement. So that leads to the corrosion of the reinforcement. Environmental effects. Micro cracks present in the concrete are the source of ingress of moisture and atmospheric carbon dioxide into the concrete, which attack reinforcement and react with various ingredients of concrete. So always there will be the micro cracks will present in the concrete that we can't able to control. At any cause, it may develop due to movement in the structure or disturbing the structure, etc. So what will happen? The source of moisture, the CO2 will enter into the concrete, which will attack the reinforcement to start corrosion and some reactions or ingredients with the concrete. Next point, in aggressive environment, concrete structures will deteriorate faster and strength life of concrete structures will be severely reduced. In some structures, example in nearby coastal areas or nearby more windy in hilly areas, etc., or landslide areas, so that may lead to in aggressive environment concrete structures. So So the structures will get defects or a failure may occur easily. So that can be reduced by taking proper care or proper design. So poor quality materials used. As we said earlier, material should be tested at some time, at least so that only basic test at least, so that only the materials can be suitable for construction or not, that we can be identified. So the quality of materials used in construction should be ensured by means of various tests as specified by IS code suits. For example, if you are taking cement, there are many tests. So at least some basic tests should be carried out in the field to avoid the failure in the structure. Alkali aggregate reaction and sulfate attack results in early deterioration. So early failure may due to alkali aggregate reaction, sulfate attack, that is due to with the help of aggregates. So proper aggregate should be taken with a proper test condition and also get satisfied. Clay materials in the fine aggregate may weaken the mortar aggregate. So you may see in when you are kid, if you are playing in sand, not M sand, I'm meaning the sand, manal. Okay, you may see in some clay particles that the optical objects may detect the structure, but nowadays we are using only M sand or quarry sand, whatever it is, that don't have the clay particles. So that clay particles in fine aggregate, that manal, may reduce the strength. Salinity causes corrosion of reinforcement bars as well as the deterioration of the struck concrete. So the next point, quality of supervision, that is an important thing. The construction work should be carried out as per the specifications. Adhere to specified water cement ratio, control strength, permeability and durability of concrete. Insufficient vibration may result in porous and honeycombed structure, whereas excess vibration may cause segregation. So if in a site, if you are doing in the concrete, if the vibrations not did properly, what will happen? Honeycomb, you know that honeycomb, that is stain kudu. In Tamil we used to say that. It may like some, I think if you will study this in concrete laboratory this semester, there is one test name slump cone, that if you are not doing compaction properly, after removal of slump cone, you can able to see that the structure is not finished. It may be seeing like honeycomb in shape. So that's what here it is mentioned. And whereas excess vibration means what will happen means if the vibration is more time, then all the coarse aggregate will settle down and all the cement slurry, we used to tell that word cement slurry, cement and fine aggregate will come at the top and whereas coarse aggregate will settle at the bottom. So that also leads to improper in strength. And water cement ratio is important thing. More water will also leads to slurry and less water will also now leads to less bonding between the concrete. Deterioration due to corrosion, that is what are the effects? Spalling of concrete, yes, that's what I'm stating. Spalling of concrete means falling from the structure, mainly from slabs in housing board house. Normally newspapers or any news you can see that the roof has been fallen or some parts of roof has been fallen, that is termed as the spalling of concrete. Cracks parallel to the reinforcement, cracks will develop throughout the length, spalling at the edges, particularly at the corners. Swelling of concrete, it may detect the structure. Dislocation, misplaced dislocation means settlement, again leads to settlement. Internal cracking and reduction in area of steel of reinforcement. Rehabilitation. Rehabilitation consists of restoring the structure to service level. It once had and no lost. If the structure is going to be rehabilitated, then at least it will lead to its complete service level or at least some time up to where the minimum condition needs. And it had no, once you fit it, and you can save the structure also. Strengthening consists in endowing the structure with a service level higher than initially planned by modifying the structure, not necessarily damaged. So that is the main thing. So strengthening will be increase the service level of the structure only, not it will damage the structure.